Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit a multinomial probit regression model with a continuous predictor variable. I'm also going to show you how to test hypotheses about the parameters in the model, how to estimate predicted probabilities from the model, and how to create some graphs when we're finished. I'm going to be using the SysDSN1 dataset, and you can download this by typing webuse SysDSN1. I've also described the variables we'll be using for this model. Insure is the categorical dependent variable that we'll be using. It's the type of insurance a person has. And I'm going to be using age measured in years as the continuous predictor. Here I can see that the value label insure is attached to insure, so I've typed label list insure so I can view the various categories of insure. So one represents indemnity, two represents prepaid, and three represents uninsure. So let's begin by going to statistics, and I'm going to select categorical outcomes, and then multinomial probit regression. So in the model tab, I'm going to begin by selecting the dependent variable, which is insure. And then for my independent variables, I'm going to click this little three-dot box here. I'm going to leave factor variable selected as well as main effect specified here. And then for the variable, I'm going to select age. So age is a continuous variable, so I need to check this little box underneath C dot, and that tells Stata that age is a continuous variable. We're going to ignore base for this example. So next I click add to var list, and this will add this to our variable list. And when I click OK, I can see that it's been added to the list of independent variables. So let's click submit and see what this does. So if I scroll back up, I can see that the command is mprobit, and the categorical dependent variable is insure, and then the continuous predictor is age. And if I scroll down, I can see that there are some model level statistics here at the top. I have the number of observations, walled chi-square along with its p-value. And then here in below, I see a table of coefficients. So I see three of the three outcome categories, indemnity, prepaid, and uninsure. And for two of those, well, the top one here, indemnity, is the base outcome. And then for the other two, I see parameter estimates or coefficients. One for the intercept or cons, and the other for age. And I see that for both of the other two categories, prepaid and uninsure. For each of these estimated coefficients, I also get a standard error, a z-statistic, a p-value, and a 95% confidence interval. Now, I may prefer to use a different category as the base outcome. So if I come back over here to the dialog box, I can check this little box and then type 3, because 3 is the category for uninsured. So let's use uninsured as our base outcome. So I've typed 3 here for base outcome, and I'm going to click OK. So now if I scroll back up, the command is still mprobit, insure is still our dependent variable, age is still our independent variable, and now we've added the option base outcome 3, and that's what tells Stata that we want to use category 3 of our dependent variable as the base outcome. Now, notice we have two estimates of the coefficient age, and we might want to test that coefficient is equal to 0. I can do that by typing test parm c.age. Oops, I need to spell it correctly. Okay, and the c dot in front of age explicitly tells Stata that age is a continuous variable. And what it's going to do then is test that the three age coefficients are simultaneously equal to 0. So we get an omnibus chi-square test here at the bottom along with the p-value for that test. The next thing that we might want to do is estimate some predicted probabilities of the outcome. So I'm going to go to statistics, and then I'm going to scroll almost all the way to the bottom where it says post-estimation. And this opens the post-estimation selector, and I can do lots of things here. I can do goodness of fit analysis, do some predictions, tests, contrasts. I want to select marginal effects, estimated means, interactions. So I'm going to click plus to expand this menu. And here I'm going to select basic and low dimensional analysis. Let's just keep it simple here for the beginning. So I'm going to click launch, and this opens the margins dialog box. We'll come back to outcome here. I'm in the main tab. We'll come back to outcome in a moment. I'm going to skip down to covariate to compute margins, contrasts, or effects across. And for the covariate, I'm going to select age, because that's the only covariate in the model. Age is continuous, so I need to specify the values to compute estimates at. So I'm going to compute predicted probabilities at age 20 in increments of 10 through age 80. And that's how I type that, 20, 10 in parentheses, and then 80. So age 20 to 80 in increments of 10 years. So then I'm going to click OK. And let's come over here and take a look at the output. So the command, the dialog box issued the command margins using the option at age equals 20 through 80 in increments of 10. That's what that 20, 10, 80 refers to. Below that, I see a list of predictions. So one predict one refers to the insurance category or the dependent variable category indemnity. That's outcome one. Outcome category two is prepaid. Okay, and then outcome category three is uninsured. And then below that, I see a list of ats. So at age 20, at age 30, and so forth. So if I scroll down here and look at the output, what this shows me are predicted probabilities of someone at that age belonging to that particular insurance category. So for instance, here at the top, this first row, this is the probability that a 20-year-old has indemnity insurance. Okay, so that's about 43% if we were to round it, or 0.43. For someone who is age 30, the predicted probability of them having indemnity insurance is about 45% or 0.45 rounded. For each of these predictions, I get a standard error, I get a Z statistic, a p-value, as well as a 95% confidence interval. So the next thing that I might want to do is I might want to plot these predictions. So I'm going to go back, I'm going to go back to the post estimation selector and select profile plots after marginal analysis and then click launch. And this opens the margins plot dialog box. So in the main tab, I'm going to begin by selecting at age to define my variables that define the x-axis. And let's just click submit and see what that does. So what this shows us then is on the horizontal axis, we have age, 20 through 80 in increments of 10. The vertical axis is the probability of belonging to one of those outcome categories. And then I have three lines, and each of those lines has dots along there, and those dots are the predicted probability of belonging to that category, given that you're a particular age, 20, 30, 40, and so forth. And then each of those, around each of those dots, we have a 95% confidence interval. Now, we may want to change some things about this. One of the things we may want to change is the number of lines. So it looks like uninsured is fairly constant here at the bottom, and we might want to restrict our graph just to the other two categories, outcome one and outcome two, the indemnity and the prepaid group. So let's close this graph and close this dialog box. And I'm going to go back over here to the margins dialog box. So I'm selecting basic and low dimensional analysis again and clicking launch. And now here in the outcome section at the very top of the margins dialog box, I'm going to select one and two, and that's going to select the two outcome categories for the predictions. So I'm going to click OK again, and I've still left age selected and age 20 through 80 in increments of 10. So when I click OK, what this is going to do then is restrict this only to people with indemnity insurance or prepaid insurance. And if I look at the command here, I see these two options have been added. So I have predict equation one and predict equation two. If I scroll down, I see those probabilities again. So let's go back and graph those. So let's go back to profile plots and marginal analysis. And again, this opens that margins plot dialog box. So I'm going to select age, or at age again for the variable that defines the x-axis. And let's click submit again to see what that looks like. Okay, so again, we have the horizontal axis is age, the vertical axis is the probability of belonging to that category, and then I see a legend here at the bottom. Now, the legend says equation 1 equals 1, or equation equals 1 and equation equals 2. What I might want to do is change that to the actual labels of the categories. So I can do that by going over here to legend in the dialog box. I'm going to click the legend tab. And here I'm going to check the box that says override default keys. And next, I'm going to type 1, and in double quotes, I'm going to type indemnity. Indemnity, if I can spell it. And then 2 is prepaid. And let's click submit and see what that looks like. Okay, so now we've changed the legend to display indemnity and prepaid rather than those equation labels. Another thing that I might want to do is change the label of the horizontal axis here. That's probably descriptive for the researcher, but probably not for someone who sees this, so a person who reads the manuscript later. So let's go to the x-axis tab here, and I'm going to type age and then put years in parentheses and click OK. And now we've changed the label there. We could do the same thing for the y-axis if we wanted to. Okay, so that's how we can create a graph of the predicted probabilities. So let me show you another trick here. I'm going to close these dialog boxes, and then I'm going to come back to the history window and right-click any of those commands, and then I'm going to select Select All. And then I'm going to right-click again and select Send Selected to Do File Editor. And what that's going to do is send all those commands that were generated by the dialog boxes to a do file. And now we can save this and rerun it anytime we want. It also gives us a chance to learn the names of some of these options that we've used along the way. So this is a handy way to learn new commands if you're going to type them into your do file later on. So that's how we can fit a multinomial probit regression model with a continuous predictor, test some hypotheses about the parameters, estimate some predicted probabilities, and create some graphs. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.